And quest friend. Okay, you got a dojo, got a professor, got a sensei. Okay, step out. Tie on your belts. Okay, and step up, down, right foot out and elbows. Hey! All right, okay. Everybody's gotten warmed up on their own. We're going to start with our stationary karate traditional Kenpo drills. So, a good horse stance. Okay, we'll just start with some punches first. So we'll start with front punches. First, right hand first. What is that noise? Is that me? I don't think so. Okay. And one, hey, two, hey, three, hey, four, hey, five, hey, six, hey, seven, hey, eight, hey, nine, hey, ten, hey. What kind of strike do you want to do? Oh, we haven't done that one in a long time. All right. Dragon's mouth, straight out in front like this. Ready? One,
hey.
Two,
hey.
Three,
hey.
Four,
hey.
Five,
hey.
Six,
hey.
Seven,
hey.
Eight,
hey.
Nine,
hey.
Ten,
hey.
All right, that's a good one. All right, here's what we're gonna do for this one. Like our marching drills, except it's mostly stationary. We're gonna move a little bit. So we're gonna start with our, we're gonna do front kick, step down, reverse punch. And then we're gonna come back. We're gonna keep that hand down, and then we're gonna kick at that side. Front kick, step down, reverse punch. So we'll step back to our center every time. Okay, get in a good position there. We'll start kicking with our right leg first, so put your right hand out in front. And one,
hey,
and key eye on the punch. And step back, keep that hand out. Two,
hey,
and step back. Three,
hey,
and step back. Four,
hey,
and step back. Five,
hey,
and step back. Six,
hey,
hey, and step back. Seven,
hey,
and step back. Eight,
hey,
and step back. Nine,
hey,
and back. Last one, ten,
hey,
and back. Good, okay. Let's do when we did, I don't remember if we did it on Wednesday or Monday, but we're going to do crescent kick, step down, cross, block, cross, chop. So the important things here is to make sure that you're landing in a good solid horse stance. Don't fall into the stance. Cross on top, closed hand for the block, cross on top, open chop for that chop, okay? Starting with our right leg first. Okay, and one, kick, step down, cross, block, cross, chop, and back. Other side, two, block, and chop, step back. Three, and block, chop, and back. Four, block, chop, and back. Five, block, chop. Six, kick, block, chop, and back. Seven, block, chop, and back. Eight, block, chop, and nine, block, chop. Make sure you're using both hands on the blocks and the chops. 10. Step down, block, block, chop, and back.
Nice.
Okay. Let's do, that's pretty good. Good job. All right. We're going to do now, we did some of the stationary marching drills out of our katas on Wednesday. We're going to do one today that we didn't do on Wednesday. It's going to be attacker number 6 from pinyon 3. Attacker number 6, pinyon 3. So on this one, we're going to start here again. We're going to start with our right leg in front. And it's going to be high block, low strike, uppercut. Then we'll come back and we'll go left leg in front. Left, right, left, right. It's going to be awkward for you.
Yeah.
Backwards, I know. And step back. And again, step in with the other side. And it's 1, 2, 3, 4. Step back. This is number 4. Step in. High, high, low, high. Step back. 6. 1, 2, 3, 4. Step back. Step in. What number is this? 6, 1, 2, 3, 4. Step back. 7, 1, 2, 3, 4. Step back. Step in. 8, 1, 2, 3, 4. Step back. And in 9. High, high, low. Uppercut. Step back. And last one. 10, 1, 2, 3, 4. And back. Good. All right. You guys working up a little bit of a sweat? I know I am. Okay. Let's move on then, because we don't have a lot of time. I had a request for touching on grabs today, so we're going to do that, and I'm going to just take a selection from the curriculum, so we're not going to, like, go in a row, or I'm going to kind of bounce around, because we've got advanced kids here, we've got both high-ranking and lower-ranking adults, so we're going to touch on a little bit of everything. So the first one we're going to do is looking in the mirror. Looking in the mirror. So let me take my watch for this. All right. So looking in the mirror, your partner grabs both hands. There's a way that we learned it a while back, and there's a way that professor is teaching it now. Okay. So don't be confused, but ask a question if you're not following. Okay. So here is the new way that professor is teaching this. You still look at your mirror, look at your mirror, okay? And now you're just going to reach underneath, try to get closer, reach underneath and put your thumb on the back of the wrist, peel your hand out, and immediately you're in Kota Gaish, okay? So that is how professor's teaching it now. Also acceptable is looking in your mirror, grabbing underneath, peeling your hand, and knife hand across the back. That is another way of doing it, but that's not how professor's teaching it right now. So you can know both ways, okay? So we're gonna go look in your mirror, grab the back of the wrist, peel it, Kota Gaish, okay? So with our shadow partners, it's gonna look like this. Do it with me as a shadow partner. So you're going to look at your mirror, grab, peel it off, Kota Gaish, okay? One more time. Look at your mirror, grab, so your thumbs are pointed outwards, Kota Gaish. Now let's follow up with the takedown, okay? So we go look in the mirror, grab, Kota Gaish. Go ahead and go down. I won't. He's down, okay. And from there, of course, you can finish them how you normally would. They can't even see you. I'm just going to punch you, and we're done. Okay. I already stepped on your hair. Okay? So, one more time. And look in the mirror, grab, grab, kudagaishi. You don't have to go down, okay? So with our shadow partner this time, we're gonna go look in the mirror, grab, grab, step into that as you would be taking them down. One more time, ready? And I'm gonna face this way. And I'm gonna face this way. And look in the mirror, grab, grab, kudagaishi. Okay? Any questions on that one? That one is looking in the mirror. Any questions?
I have a question.
Okay.
I like doing that, but I don't know how to show power in it without hurting my uke.
Ooh, that's a really good question, Annika. Okay. So what part are you having a hard time showing power in?
Well, if I do it too fast, I'm going to hurt their wrists. So how do I make it seem powerful without hurting my uke?
Okay, so that's a great question, Annika. So this is all about control. It's not necessarily about power, right? Because you're not going to be able to necessarily outpower someone like your dad because he's so big, right? But, come here. So it's not like throwing your strongest punch or your strongest kick. In this case, it's being able to affect his balance and get him, it's pain compliance. So you just have to just a little bit. If you can get your dad kind of buckling his knees down like that and tapping, you've done it great. So the important part is going slow, getting the control, okay? And when your partner starts doing that bit, you know that you've broken his balance and that you've got the control. So don't worry as much on this one about the power. It's more about the control, get that wrist lock, and being able to break his balance with that. Does that make sense?
Yes. I'm more concerned about demos because I know it's accurate if you do.
Uh-oh, you cut out. It's accurate if you do what?
Sort of boring because
everyone's cutting out.
Yeah, I'm not hearing her.
Okay, so we have her. So I want to find how I can get most accurate.
Sensei,
sorry, we have some.
I don't know.
Oh, bandwidth. Okay. Maybe if we can spotlight Annika. Oh, they're awesome.
Yeah.
Okay, so when she comes back, there she is. Let's try to spotlight Annika and maybe she can demonstrate what she's asking.
I'm trying to ask is when look boring because all it is they're moving their hands. And in any technique, if you have a good uke who maybe would just like to be nice to you, they would fall down for you. So it would just look like your uke is just falling down for you. But I want to make sure I'm making it look powerful while also being accurate.
Okay, so that's where having a good uke comes in, and your dad is a great uke. So you just need to talk to each other, and you need to say, Dad, don't like go down or don't tap unless I'm actually getting this lock on you, right?
Okay.
Am
I will.
Am I not understanding the question?
No, I think so.
Yes, thank you.
I will.
Good uke.
I will be an uke that doesn't fall down.
So unless
you don't need to be parents about it.
Lock, so she'll learn control by you have to tell her when she's got that lock. So
right.
don't tap, don't go down for her unless she's got that lock. I mean, she's an advanced strength now, so she should be able to learn that control when is too far. She'll never be able to know how far is too far unless you guys are talking to each other. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Good. That was a great question. Okay. All right. Let's go to the next one. This is a higher rank technique. I believe it's round one for adults. And it's called lifting. No, it's not round one, but it's a higher rank one. So it's called lifting elbow. I think this is green actually. So lifting elbow. This is going to be from a grab here. Okay. From a gi grab. This is We're going to go ahead and trap here. Punch, just to loosen them up, because we always like to do that. Then you're going to reach up underneath, and your finger is going to hook right into their elbow. From here, you're going to pull your elbow. I'm going to turn it to a different angle in a minute. But you're basically going to take your elbow and pull it towards behind you, pulling their elbow to your belt. See, I'm not lifting my elbow up. I'm pulling it in like a snake and pulling his elbow towards my belt. From here, he should be tipping sideways because I've got him off balance. I'm going to, with my hand here, make a V out of his neck and shoulder, and then the takedown is here. Okay, with a hammer or a chop. Okay, try not to be too much of it. Okay, okay, so we're gonna turn this way. Okay, so again, he's grabbing here. I'm gonna trap and strike. Sit him up. I go underneath to his elbow, and I'm gonna pull it to my belt. So you can see my elbow is not lifting. I'm pulling it in and keeping it tight like a snake. From here, this puts him off balance. I'm going to create the gap there by just moving my hand to the side. Hand comes up. That's your takedown there. Okay, big solid strike on this part of the neck. All right, so let's try that with a shadow partner. Okay? So we're going to trap, step back, strike, lift up underneath. Pull it to your hip. So just pull that arm straight into your belt. Tilt their head sideways. Hammer strike down. Okay? So one more time. Trap, step back, strike. Lift underneath to the hook of the elbow. Pull it into your hip. Tilt the head sideways. Hammer them down to the ground. Do we have questions on that one? We can repeat it a couple more times. So that one is lifting elbow. Are we good on that one? Yeah? Okay. Awesome. I have this in the wrong view.
11 minutes left, Sensei.
How many?
11.
Why does it go so fast? Okay. All right. Thank you. Okay. So the next one is Bear Hug Angry Mule. This is higher up on the list for our advanced kids. So I want to make sure that we get this. So this is Bear Hug number 2. Garrick is going to go ahead and grab me from behind. Let's put you behind me here. Go ahead and grab me from behind. He's got my arms in here. Okay, just like Bear Hug number 1. I'm going to trap. If I can hit them, great. I'm going to stomp down on that foot, and then the important part is as I go out to the side, my body drops down and my hands go up. Okay? So one more time. Trap, headbutt if we can, stomp, step out, hands go up. Then it's elbow 1, groin 2, the third strike, here, stand up straight for me. The third strike is straight up the chin, which would knock him backwards. But because we don't want to accidentally hit our partners in the dojo, instead of going to the chin, we're just going to bump him backwards with that fist. Last thing, boom, back kick, because that's the angry mule. Okay? Oh, thank you, Noble. I needed that. Thank you. Okay, so let's do that. Okay, can you do that again? They didn't hear you. That's his donkey. Okay, and let's do this again. Okay, so he grabs, trap the hands, headbutt, stomp, step out, drop down, and the arms go up. Then 1, groin 2, uppercut 3. Make sure your partner gets out of your way before you, boom, throw that big back kick. Okay? So, with shadow partner, we're going to go ahead and face this way, shadow partners. So, trap, stomp, step out, arms up. 1, two, three, back kick, cross the guard. Bear hug two, angry mule. Here we go again. Ready? Trap. Stomp. Step out. Elbow one, two, three, angry mule. Cross cover guard. Angry mule. One more time. And trap. Stomp. Step out. Elbow one, two, uppercut. Kick. And cross cover guard. Angry mule. All right. Any questions on that one?
We might need Emily to demo that one again. I'm not sure.
Would she be awesome on that? Okay, let's see it. And thank you, Jay, for being the UK. That was awesome. I love it. Okay. Anybody else want a demo? No? No? We're good. Okay, no questions on that one.
Oh, everybody maybe comment. Bennett wants to demo, I think.
Bennett. Let's see Bennett. Okay, Bennett. Awesome. Nice job, Bennett.
All right, Bennett.
Awesome. So I didn't mention this. I should have been doing that one backwards. If you're a righty, use your right hand. If you're a lefty, use your left hand. That's going to be part of this learning curve here. Okay, that was awesome. Everybody do great. Okay, last one. Okay, this one's super fun. Let's do Tashi.
What?
Tashi. Okay, so this is another knee grab. Okay, from here, we have to be careful with our partners so we don't actually hit them too hard. For our adults, remember that this is supposed to be fast. Boom, boom, right? We're supposed to be stepping back to lengthen them out. The right hand comes up underneath, and it's going to go right above the elbow. This is meant to be popping of the elbow. Then it comes back up, around, and break them down. Then we go, if their head is low, as we come back, it can be one, two, or if their head is not low, we could go just straight. We could go to the face. We could go here with a back knuckle strike and left kick, chasing them down. Okay, so one more time. So he grabs, actually, let's face this way. Okay, so he grabs. I'm gonna step back. Then it's right hand up under. So one, two. Okay, now what happens if their arms don't come off? It doesn't matter, right? So one, two. Say I can't get his arms off because he's a really big square guy. I can't get his arms off. That's okay. I can still go one, two. Eventually his arms are going to come off. Okay? Because it hurts too bad. So here we go. Step back. Go one, two, one, two, three. Okay? So let's do this with shadow partner. Oh, is there a question?
Question.
Yeah, I didn't hear. Is it a left kick or is it a right kick?
It's a left kick. So a bit different from some of the other stuff we do. So you're stepping back with your left foot initially. So it's a step back here. One, two, one, two, three. Yeah? Or did I change it up on everybody?
Yeah, that's okay.
You never know. I'm going backwards these days. Okay, so let's do it as shadow partners. Okay, so we step back, left foot, then it's right hand up underneath, left hand's up close. So one, right hand comes around, two, and then one, two, three with the left foot, and cross cover guard, that's Tashi. Here we go again. I'm going to turn sideways and you just face the front form. Okay, so step back. One, up over two, back fist, punch, left kick, Tashi. Okay, one more time. And step back. One, two, one, two, three. Tashi, you're in this case, you're chasing the person down. You're not going away from them. So that's why you're moving into them at the end of that one. All right. Any questions on that? What time do we have, Sensei?
3 minutes, Sensei.
Oh, man. All right. So that was a good start for grabs. I had a list of about three other ones I wanted to try to get through today, so we'll just have to keep it there. I wanted to make sure everybody is aware that the email we sent out about the private lessons is for the adults too. So guys, feel free to set up a private lesson with any of the instructors. If the instructor that you want is not on the list for private lessons, we'll add them. We'll just find out what their availability is and we'll add them so they can work with you. But that would be a perfect time to do kata, since this is not the easiest way to get kata work done unless we're doing like the warm-up katas, you know. But if you need individual work on katas, book your private lesson and we can do it then. What else? Kids belt test tonight. How many of the advanced kids on this call are doing the belt test tonight? Raise your hand. Anybody? Alexander, are you? Oh, he's okay. No stripes on that one yet. Ben, are you doing the belt test tonight? Are you ready to test or no? Benjamin? Yeah. Are you ready to test, Benjamin?
What?
Are you ready to test? Do you have all your stripes?
Here.
Annika, does that mean you're testing? What do you got on that, Aunt Annika? You have blue?
My mom is a mute.
I can't see. Sensei, can you see?
I'm trying to spotlight her.
You have a blue stripe, Annika?
She's missing yellow?
No, she's got yellow on the end.
Oh, okay.
No, she's missing white and blue.
White and blue. Well, white's easy. She just has to do a book report, right?
Book report, though.
Yeah.
Gotta do a book report. What's that?
I haven't memorized my kata yet.
Okay. So you have maybe next month?
Yeah. Yeah.
If I can get the book.
Okay.
What's the book?
Little Eagle.
Oh, that's a fun one.
I don't have that one. Okay.
Okay. All right.
I'll leave it on your porch, but...
Okay, so book those private lessons. We're happy to do them for y'all. And reach out to me if there's something you want me to cover in class. But this is fun. I hope you had a good time. I'm sweating. I hope you are a little. And we'll see you next time. Thanks, guys.
Thanks.
Bye. Thanks,
Bye.
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 Bye. Bye. Bye.
Are we bowing out?
Oh my goodness. Yeah, let's do that. Sorry. Yeah. We'll do our moment stuff. Okay, front position. Thanks, Jonathan. Bow, step out. Yeah. And go ahead and take off your obis. Okay, and just, I know it's backwards, but go ahead and bow to me, bow to Shihan, Professor, Dojo. All right. Nice job, everyone.
Good work. Good work.
Okay.
Should we get some green tea?
That's nothing hard.